Welcome to the first day of February. I know a lot of guys are so happy. January imeisha. Yani, people are stepping into February in style. But I think for the boy child, the month of February is a month of reckoning because there's a day called Valentine's Day that they are always scared of, and I don't even understand why. Maybe Elvis, can you tell us why is boy child afraid of Valentine's Day?
I don't think we're afraid of it. It's just that we also have other things to do. You know, it's the month of football. As you guys are thinking,
my goodness.
As you guys are thinking,
oh, yeah.
Love sitting on your football.
Yes.
So, like, it's just, you know, I think Valentine's Day is something that's, you know, celebrated every day.
Mm-hmm.
If you're romantic, you're romantic throughout the year.
Yeah.
I should not buy you flowers on one day and you feel special.
Christian, do you hear this? Can you actually believe what he's saying?
It's fine. But it's all fine. You can buy the flowers every other day of the year. But on this specific day that, you know, we're celebrating Valentine's Day, it wouldn't have to buy me flowers.
We're celebrating love.
Yeah. The same way we celebrate my birthday or Christmas or Easter, we have this day where we celebrate love. So, I mean, I'm not saying it should be one-sided. Even the women should also cater to their men. So it shouldn't be one-sided.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. But let's all celebrate each other.
Yeah, I think we put a lot of unnecessary.
It's very necessary. Yeah.
It's unnecessary.
It's very necessary.
I think it's very necessary.
You can start saving from today. You'll be fine in about 2 weeks.
Yeah. 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 Precious. Use that. Kwenda sijui kampinski 5.4 sijui wacheni mtu ajikune majaneza.
What's wrong with me wanting good stuff for myself? Exactly. Anyway, guys, unfortunately, also today being the first day of February, we woke up to some very, very sad news. We lost one of the best singers in East Africa, Radio from Uganda. I think you guys know him, and if you don't know him, I know you are a Slay Queen, born a millennial, because you have to know Radio. Like, guys, what do you guys remember about him?
What do we remember? Well, like you said, he was a good musician.
Yeah.
So, I mean, all I can say for now is may his soul rest in peace.
Yeah. For me, I really, really liked one of his songs called Zuena. I don't know if we can have that song. This song was so amazing. I think it came out when we were in high school, you know, you're a teenager, you know, finding out that you're the opposite sex and everything. And me personally, I really, really love this song to death. It's just amazing. It's so unfortunate what happened to him.
Yeah, I think my sincere condolences to the family and, you know, everyone who's been affected by his death.
Mm-hmm.
He was indeed a legend.
Yes.
Gone too soon, man. It's sad that, you know, it was a bar fight.
Yeah, you know, definitely.
It's a very sad story.
Mm-hmm.
But I like how, you know, Ugandans pulled through for him. I like even the way the president was involved.
Yeah.
He contributed a lot of money.
Mm-hmm.
And I just hope that, you know, the guys behind this will, you know, justice will be found.
Yes.
Let it not just slide like that.
Yeah.
And it's a sad day for, you know, the whole of East Africa.
Yeah.
And for even Africa and the whole world. Mm-hmm. And it will be well.
Yeah, it will. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. Sorry, we came in a few minutes past the hour we were supposed to come through, but anyway, we are glad that we are able now to be here. But I know you guys are so much waiting for what we had earlier said about pole dancing. So what comes to your mind when you think about pole dancing? You know, strip clubs, erotic music. I know most of you think about that. But although there's a stigma attached to pole dancing, it is fast turning into a fitness workout. And I met a very lovely lady who has been able actually to make this a career for herself and, you know, try and show people that pole dancing does not necessarily have to be a dirty or an immoral thing, but it's actually a fitness thing that empowers a woman. Watch this video, guys. Yeah. She's called Marilyn, and she's actually a fitness trainer, but she also started this because her bosses started, as she has explained earlier, poked her that, why don't you start pole dancing as a fitness? And the moves she's making, you literally have to be fit for you to be hanging your body upside down. But the question that came to mind, and actually she admitted to this, she said that most of her clients at the beginning were expatriates, more, and very few Kenyans. Do you think, guys, are we ready for pole dancing fitness? Are we still that conservative kind of people, Elvis? What do you think?
It's a fitness thing.
Okay, I don't think we are that conservative.
If we get, I think, in, let's say, the strip club kind of way, yes. Then maybe we would think it's something that is immoral or not right. But if it's fitness, it's just getting fit, getting your body to,
agree to me to get more Kenyans should be willing to sign up and go and
pole dancing has always been seen as something evil.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. We need to get our minds off that mindset that it's something evil. Mm-hmm. It's just basically trying to get fit, making your body more fit. So why not try it out?
Elvis, I know you'll be very happy if your girlfriend took a few lessons.
I wouldn't mind, but you see, I'm also looking at it from, the business angle. Mm-hmm. Cardi B was a, skip dancer, she was a pole dancer. A lot of these celebrities these days were, one strip dancer.
Yes.
And they were very popular in their countries. Not to mean that they were doing something evil, they were just dancing, because it's also, I think, another way of dancing and working out. Because I don't think there's, okay, you have to be fit, of course, to do it. But the pole doesn't make you fit. You come when you're already fit.
Yes.
So you need to be able to do all the stunts. And so I think it can be done, as a fitness, but also as a way of making money.
Mm-hmm.
Because if someone is willing to, make it rain to see you pole dance, then why not?
Actually be able to separate themselves from this stigma that is surrounding pole dancing? Actually, can you actually do, because I asked Marilyn, what do you tell your parents? I'm a pole dancer instructor. Do they, or when you're with friends, do they stare at you? And she admitted that a lot of times she gets people who ask her, oh my God, don't you have money? They're like wondering, maybe she's doing that because she's desperate, she's out of cash. She doesn't have money. She has even had guys calling her a stripper, and that's not what she's doing. Do you think, guys, you can be able to separate yourself from this evil that surrounds it, actually?
Well, I think maybe that will come with time. Mm-hmm. For people to realize just because I am pole dancing doesn't mean that I am necessarily removing my clothes, stripping, mm-hmm. or, showing off my body or such things. So I think, that comes with time. Maybe in Kenya it's still very new, and people have associated pole dancing to strip clubs. So that's why when we see something like this,
yes.
they only think it's a stripping. Yeah, like she was saying, She's not even indecently dressed for her to do that. She's not even, she's not stripping, right?
Yes.
So it's just a whole mindset which I think would take time before Kenyans would embrace this new sport.
It's a workout.
Yeah.
I think it will definitely take time.
Mm-hmm.
Because it's very, I mean, it's the first time I'm personally seeing it. So it will take
really?
Time.
Really?
As a workout. I've never seen someone who is teaching other people this new art of working out. It's definitely new. So
yeah.
Of course it's going to take time.
Yeah.
But you know, I think times have also changed. I mean, our parents and a lot of Kenyans these days, I mean, they are very well versed with what's happening. I mean, if you look at the most searched item on Google in January,
mm-hmm.
was Samantha.
Yeah.
And so
actually
these days, I mean, information is just out there.
Yeah.
And so such stereotypes can be killed by, you know, relaying the information out there, making the information available, and doing more of what you're doing, you know, when you give them the platform, then they're able to explain themselves better.
I'm going to put you on the spot, Elvis. Would you be okay with your partner telling you that this is my profession?
Profession?
Oh.
Like, I wouldn't mind.
Oh, you wouldn't mind?
Yeah, I mean, I wouldn't mind being, you know, as long as like a better comments at the end of the day. I mean, at the end of the day, it's not a funny bread.
Yes.
I wouldn't.
So who tell me choose to get the bread you don't like?
Of course, come up next. You know, let her do what she's doing, but come up here boundaries. You know.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Let nobody touch my cooking jar. You know.
Are you gonna stop them from acting as a stripper?
See.
No, she's not a stripper.
No,
he said,
he wouldn't mind if she was a stripper.
Yes.
That's what I'm
asking. Oh, you said that?
Yeah. How do they manage?
It's all about trust, I think.
It's all about trust.
Yeah.
You
have to be.
She's old.
Yeah.
Born and good.
Seriously.
Tell us what you think, guys,
about pole dancing. Do you guys still think it's immoral? Like, guys, come on. This thing is here, and you have to be very, very fit for you to be able to do this. Because I was there when she was doing it, and you know, I could see her, you know, at the end of it.
Did you try it?
Oh my goodness, I couldn't. Have you seen me? Elvis, I was afraid that pole could come back down with me.
But it looks very well.
No! Yeah, why not? Yeah. I think it's because she said it's also empowering. You know, if you know you can do this,
yeah.
It actually empowers you as a woman. Yeah. Now, something interesting also happened this week. We had the much-awaited swearing-in ceremony of NASA leader Raila Odinga that took place on Tuesday. But the twist to it is that the deputy, who was supposed to be sworn in as the deputy, Mr. Kalonzo Musyoka, was apparently MIA. And you know, guys, Kenyans on Twitter, you guys need a medal for whatever you get these memes, you need a medal for it. And they came up with such hilarious memes, you know, to just depict that picture of Mr. Kalonzo not being available. I think you guys saw it. What do you guys think? I think people are just too harsh to Mr. Kalonzo Musyoka. Guys.
I don't think they're too harsh. But I think Kenyans are very creative. And I like how in every situation, we always find something funny to laugh about.
Yes.
So I think it's very nice. And you feel nice to be Kenyan. When we have such many situations, anything that comes up, you always find so many memes. So many challenges. So for me, I think it's a good thing that Kenyans can be that creative. So I'll not look at it as your negative, that will be too harsh on Kalonzo. He was emotional.
But he explained it. He was allegedly was held hostage somewhere.
I think if there's one opportunity that Kalonzo wasted in vindicating himself against all the names he's been called, then this was the one opportunity he really wasted.
Yes.
And I don't see how he can come back from this or spin this to, you know, try and look like the victim or to justify why he wasn't there. It was an opportunity that I personally feel he really wasted it. And now, most of us now believe all those names that, you know, people have been calling over the years.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I don't see the humor in all this name calling.
Mm-hmm.
I see, you know, I see mockery and I see cyberbullying.
Yeah, actually,
that's it.
I don't think if you're finding anything funny,
yes,
it's just cyberbullying.
There's nothing funny about it.
Yeah.
For him to have even gone to the extent of being a voice model.
Yeah.
And
is it affected
and, you know,
me somehow?
I mean, for me, there's nothing to laugh about.
Yes.
There's nothing.
So you don't find anything funny at all?
They are funny, but we're not finding the situation funny.
No, the situation is not funny, but
yeah.
As in the fact that we as Kenyans are always so creative and always look for the light at the end of the tunnel is what, for me, I'm saying is a good thing. The memes are funny, they don't have an issue.
I think we Kenyans just rush to create these memes without caring or getting concerned about this person's emotions. Do you remember Jimmy Gates and what happened to him when he was being interviewed? Yeah, we rush into creating these memes. Of course, they're funny, but I think we should put into consideration a person's, you know, feelings, because just like putting a meme of, you know, a miniature. My goodness, what is that? Kenyans, come on. This is just cyberbullying at its best. Of course, we like to laugh, but sometimes put in some consideration.
Yeah.
It's not
funny. Imagine what that is doing to, you know, his sons.
Yeah,
his
exactly.
His family,
yes.
His relatives.
I think you guys are overreacting.
I'm not overreacting.
Seriously. I think it's supposed to be light. You guys are taking it too heavy. It's supposed to be light and funny, and as in all this all these things that you guys are saying, it's like you've really taken it on a whole new light.
Mm-hmm.
Like, calm down, guys.
Mm-hmm.
It's never that serious. As in, this is a light moment.
Okay.
I mean, it's just light. Let me just say that.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think we'll never be for me, for personally, I feel like, okay, if it's a meme you want to create about me, let's all, both of us, laugh about it. But not only you that you're laughing about it. Let's laugh.
I think he deserves it. He's been turning 2 days now. He should turn some more. I think he deserves it, honestly. Because, man, that was, yeah.
But it was out of his control. He couldn't actually.
So then he was out of his control. Why is he getting emotional?
Yeah.
Because
why
people didn't know that.
But laugh about it then. It's not of my control.
Okay, guys.
You know, accept and move on.
Yeah, okay, guys. I think we will never be on that particular topic. Well, there's a study that has been conducted. And I'll start with you, Christine.
Okay,
the study says that it explains why it is beneficial for you to have adulterous fantasies during sex. They are saying it's very good for your relationship.
How? What is good?
Okay, let me read this small script. According to the study, the act is not a sign of weakness, but serves to strengthen relationships. Having adulterous fantasies during sex may strengthen a relationship. Some couples take fantasies to a different level by watching their partners being unfaithful. During the study, men were found to be the ones who got aroused by the idea of their partners having sex with someone else. And I was like, I mean, isn't this already happening in Kenya? Like, aren't people in relationship and having adulterous thoughts already? Isn't this something that's already happening?
How would we know if it's in their thoughts?
Christian.
I wouldn't know if it's happening.
Okay, what do you think about this study?
I totally disagree.
Okay.
I disagree because that's just encouraging cheating. Because you read the line that some people
yes.
like to see that one.
Yes.
I think it's nonsense. I don't agree with it at all. I don't understand why I need to think about someone else when I'm with my partner. When I'm with another person, we let her be thinking about someone. Like, it's an ongoing cycle. So when does it stop? To me, that's just nonsense. I don't agree with that at all. I think you be aroused by your partner and you should be attracted to your partner only.
And this, I saw that you had to take a glass of water before.
All cheating on me already is just a turn off.
Yeah.
Like that's just a turn off. Like, you know, and me thinking about someone else, I mean, my partner should be the one person I'm thinking about constantly.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, they should be the one person that...
My
girlfriend, also!
Can this girlfriend please comment?
Like you should be there, both body, mind.
Yeah.
So like, it's you should be right there in the mood. So you're thinking about someone else. You're not making love. You're doing something else.
But do you think?
I don't think, you know, cheating starts in the head. You know? It's me imagining me with someone else. Me seeing them, you know, doing other things.
Mm-hmm.
That's how cheating starts.
Yeah, well,
and so you never be loved. So when I'm with that person that I'm thinking about, who will I be thinking about?
Exactly.
But do you think
so
that this is the case right now? Do you think this is the case right now with the kinds of relationship we see outside here, you know, someone just calling you, taking you out and expecting, you know, for you to end up in his bed or whatever, and then the next day you just behave like nothing happened. Do you think that is the thing that is happening now when you say you have to bond? Because I think most relationships now lack that bond that you are talking about.
Yeah, but I feel like what you're talking about is a completely different aspect.
Yeah.
Which you're talking about with one extent.
Yeah.
Yes.
So, I mean, in that sense, maybe as at that time I'm thinking about you and I'm seeing you. I think those are two completely different scenarios.
Mm-hmm.
Because this one, on the one hand, is I'm in a relationship with someone.
Yes.
Every time I'm with them, I need to be thinking about someone else, you know, to perform.
Yes.
Which I think is wrong, and like I said, I don't see why we need to encourage adultery. Like, we believe it's wrong and we should not be encouraging it whatsoever.
Yes. So you guys are like, you should go into a convent and start teaching guys about abstinence and stuff. Because
no,
I can't
really.
See
if you're,
not
if
not
you're
really.
In marriage, why are you thinking about another man or another woman?
Yeah.
But we had a conversation earlier, we said that, you know, in marriage you start up, you know, there's that spark, and then after some time that spark like fades. So
but you reckon
then why do you think when you marry this person, there are other things that are attracting you to this person?
Yes.
So when that infatuation fades,
mm-hmm.
that love fades,
mm-hmm.
there are other things that are still attracting you to this person. So regardless, in the bedroom things should not be difficult, I believe. Because intimacy would still be there, because intimacy is not just the act, it's the feelings and all that goes around with it.
Do you
so
guys think there's a difference?
Hey.
There's a difference.
Hey.
Do you guys think there's a difference between someone having adulterous thoughts and someone introducing sex toys? Is there a difference to, you know, just to bring that, rekindle whatever that you are talking about?
I think sex toys is then another totally different conversation.
Mm-hmm.
Because
how? It's just the same thing. I'm having adulterous thoughts,
mm-hmm.
or
but
I'm not having adulterous thoughts, and I want us to have sex toys in the bedroom.
Then, you know, you can, then you're spicing things up between the two of you. If
yes.
you agree on introducing the sex toys,
mm-hmm.
then it means you guys maybe are okay with it, and you want to spice things up in the bedroom.
Yes.
So that's a conversation between you and your partner,
yeah.
which you're either okay with or not okay with. Having adulterous thoughts, then that's another different. This is, isn't it umbilical for what you
said? Having adulterous
thoughts,
that's already wrong. So,
you have never had an adulterous thought ever.
I see. No, you're going to be football. I'm a...
What do you think about football?
Scientifically, helps you to, you know.
Football.
True.
Maybe we're thinking about
maybe
football.
My goodness. That is not even forming in your head. That's the reason why.
It's not okay.
No, the
name is
Latin.
Football, oh my God.
Seriously?
But not think about someone else.
I totally disagree.
And there are different forms of relationships these days. You know, you could just be hooking up with someone, and that's your arrangement.
Mm-hmm.
And in that arrangement, maybe you're supposed to, you can think about other people because there's no loyalty.
What
or
about?
Not. But you're in a relationship with someone, living with something,
up.
Or you're in marriage, brother.
What about? I'm having these thoughts and I don't want to commit adultery, but maybe you know, I'm fascinated by a celebrity, let's say, like, for example, Beyonce, Rihanna, and, you know, I look at her and I'm like, wow. Christine, how about that? Yeah.
Let's refer to what the good book says. The good book says, if a man looks at a woman lustfully, he's already committed adultery.
Yes.
So when you're looking at this celebrity, and my friend is all you're thinking about, it's already adultery. So don't like yourself, don't look at your wife.
Yeah,
look at your husband.
And that's the cover. You see the way he's laughing? He's like a guilty.
It's true, obviously.
All men are now guilty of being adulterers. Pazia.
True, but I have a pazia. But there's a difference. You can look at someone, yes, but lustfully. That's what the Bible says. Lustfully. That's the difference.
Yeah, true.
Okay. Okay.
We cannot argue with the
Let me hear from you before we go on. Someone is actually accusing Elvis of being double-faced. I say, my Elvis, the one supporting pole dancing. Complaining now. Macho, kukula cake in a macho is kind of cheating.
Yes,
oh wow, guys. No, just say it.
No, I tell you, say it.
Come on. Now,
yeah.
Next, there was a leaked conversation actually of, I don't know if you call him celebrity or not. You know, I think in Kenya we use this term very loosely.
Oh yeah,
we don't actually mean it. Yeah.
Yeah.
So this, it's a guy. He was actually trying to flirt with a lady through his social media handles on the DM, of course. But you know, the lady was not feeling the other person, and he actually said, "No, I'm not interested." But apparently, this other guy took it so bad. Since he's a celebrity, he thinks that no girl is allowed to say no. So he resorted to start abusing the girl. And actually this girl got so angry that he shared that screenshot. And imagine a lot of girls came out actually saying that this kind of behavior by this particular man is like common. Like, I can even show you my screenshots. And I just want to talk about celebrity and being famous. What do you guys think? Do you think most of us feel a self-entitlement since we are famous, and I come and flirt with you, Christine, so you are not allowed to say no, since I'm so-and-so, and I have like 1,000 followers on Instagram, so it's actually an honor for me to be flirting with you.
Like, it just shows me how small your brain is. Like, we can't even converse. I mean, when you think I should be attracted to you because of who you think you are in society,
yes.
Such a turn off to me. Like, I don't understand, because you're who so and so, that has nothing to do with how I feel about you, so you shouldn't feel well just because you think you're a celebrity.
And you are not. What kind of a celebrity?
No, and even if you are a celebrity,
yeah,
whatever that means,
yes,
it doesn't mean that everyone is gonna
you immediately gonna come to me, you know. Remove your celebrity status and deal with people on a human level.
You know, they feel like if I flirt with you, you should say yes. Now, let's...
Flirt or quote? Because those are two different
Okay,
things.
Quote. Flirt? It starts with a flirt first before we start quoting. I have to flirt to see if you're interested, if I'm not wrong. Yeah, exactly. So, I mean, take a broke guy. Let me give an example. A broke guy will flirt with you and think that you have to go out with him. Now, give this person money. How bad do you think this situation is going to be? It's going to be before.
So what's the question?
What goes on into your minds, really?
When?
Is this something that it's common that
as
you can
you
say?
Like,
yeah.
You feel that you're entitled to women because you have a certain status.
Mm-hmm. No. But, you know, men are different. Men are very different, and our ways of hunting, rather, are very different.
Yes.
Some men use the things that they have. Some would say, I'm driving a V8, I'm driving this and this, I own this and this. Some people will use their possessions and wealth to try and get a chick.
Mm-hmm.
And to your surprise, some ladies like, you know, such
kind
of
man.
And then there are the men who are, it's just Kiswahili. I remember when us guys were growing, it was just Kiswahili. Mwanaume likuwa vibe. Una kati ya msichana mpaka anasema, eh, uchalima, zia na vibes tu, yani. Ilikuwa tu ni Kiswahili yako.
Ameweza.
Kitambo when us guys were growing. It was just your vibe. It was not wewe ni mtoto wa nani, wewe ni nini.
Yes.
It was just you as a man.
Yes.
Na unakatia demu, unakaa hivi.
Kiswahili yako.
Demu anakuambia sawa, let me think about it. Kuja next month, hapa hapa, huko anga na masimu. Ni kupatia feedback.
Yeah.
That they've made men to become lazy.
Yeah.
So I said to talk on an Instagram, an influencer, and as I get them, you have to go fit and sell.
So sad.
No,
it's so sad.
No,
it's so sad.
Yeah.
Move on.
But it's wrong. So I think,
okay, you are being preachy to begin with.
Yes. And some ladies are different. If I work with 90%, doesn't mean it will work with everyone.
Yeah.
And so you should also, as a man, reinvent the wheel. If you're a dame, I think it's a vibe. Try another one. Because there are many ways of working. Celebrities and quotes in the DMs of ladies. Yo, madame pia wacha kuzoesha.
Machalivo.
Usikuwe excited juu msee.
Ako na dose,
yes.
Anademinio.
Anafake it,
okay.
Ama inje unafikiri.
Oh,
not to be excited about such things. I mean, I'm saying juu ya content.
I think yeah, you were saying that if Nairobi ladies could just share their DMs,
hey,
they can ruin people's careers. Like, so what is the where's the disconnect, do you think? Where's the disconnect, Christine?
The disconnect between
what? Between actually going out, look, you know, if you're searching, as he say, and getting a, you know, instead of being a 7-7, oh, you, my name is so-and-so, and I want to date.
I think, well, I think dating has become maybe difficult for everyone. So let's not just exactly the celebrities alone. I think maybe for them, they think that's the route that they should use to actually get the women, because everyone out here is trying to hunt, as Elvis calls it. So I think that's just their way of thinking, this is gonna be what's gonna put me at the lead of the pack, you know. But
yes,
that's not the right way to go about things.
Yeah,
yes.
Okay.
So,
and like, you know, times have changed also.
Yeah.
You know, Jakitabo, you take a girl out, akikubali sasa according
after two months.
Squeezy
after 2 months, I'm talking congratulations your name, Shaena.
2 months.
Musha.
2 months, I
was just talking to Shaman. Well, no, I don't know. I'm not like 2 months in Bania. 2 months, I'm better yet. I'm thinking. What's it, Ashaena? Asha Boyka?
2 months, Supreme Court. I'm just giving a
okay. Kristen, what are we dealing with here?
Men don't even have that patience anymore.
Listen.
I think 2 months.
Listen.
Actually, we've had this conversation before. Like,
listen.
2 months, a guy is just not gonna wait.
Listen, Kitambo. Kitambo, you do it for 2 months. And then you take her out, and then you do
what's the difference between Kitambo and
now? Now, Netflix and chill.
Apana, I'm stacking Netflix and chill. Maybe I just want to shake me out, but now I'm thinking, give me those 2 months to think. In those times, I
need. He's on another DM,
yeah,
of another chick.
He's already on other DMs.
Other DMs.
Squeezy, rather.
3 months, in fact. Like, it should be 3 months. There should be a 3 month rule before I give you any kind of...
In microwave generation, squeezing at the end. Pop. Isha kuwa. I'll say our population. Microwave generation, like a full unawom imeiva unadish.
Me, I don't want to believe that we are out of patient or gentleman in this society.
I don't want there anymore.
I like to like.
And this we've actually had this conversation with you.
Patient,
1 week.
We know that we're gonna go on budget 3 months. Sasa wewe ukichess kuna vitu zinakuchess. Utangoja 2 months na unachessiwa.
Patient guys, please.
Just kuna wasewa zuri hapa nje. Enda church utapata wasewa.
Doesn't mean anyway.
Exactly.
It's true. It's a good guy.
Yule Elvis. We can't use a we don't know.
Mom, just don't think a church guy is a good guy. Them are dangerous.
Exactly, very dangerous guys.
No, I can't
experience.
Do you want to share?
Let me read one comment. What is saying here? Yo, see, Apple dancing, Ilians, and Tambo, 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 Tambo,
Tambo,
Tambo, okay. Really?
Yeah.
Oh, but you know she went to uni. So we guys are coming to the end of this discussion, guys. Thank you so much, everyone, for your comments and for telling us what you think about the show.
I'm going to
back in the day, we used to Tatiana. Even if we were doing shit, we used to Tatiana. And we would, you guys would make us wait for such a long time. These days, you
so
guys...
So can we get back to
Nini sasa ndo mmeharibu vitu. Squeezy nikiingia tu pale hi hi. Imagine we chatted the whole night.
Yeah, ndo I expect me too.
The whole night
is 3 months.
Kitambo ilikuwa posta wani wanafunzi ifike. Squeezy picha the whole night ni big deal. Pole bana. Make that nigga chase.
Kabisa.
I think we should go back to back in the days. We should go back to back in the days, actually. Yeah. Okay, guys, thank you so much for staying with us, for tuning in. Please follow Nairobi News on Facebook, on Instagram for this and more hot
Snapchat
stories.
Yeah.
On Snapchat. Hey, took a Snapchat here.
Yeah,
Telegram.
Everywhere.
YouTube at Nairobi News. Yanni, we have at our website also, nairobinews.co.ke. You guys, you are missing out a lot if you haven't followed those handles yet. But anyway, I'm your host, Sylvania Bani, Christine, and Elvis. Bye.
Adios. That was good.